Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Stellaris, the strategy game, the newest strategy game released by Paradox, unless maybe, I'm thinking maybe, Hearts of Iron 4 may have come out. May have come out most recently. I'm not sure. Either way, this is one of the newest strategy games by Stellaris. Or by Paradox. Quick notes. This is going to be going up on YouTube. Awesome. I know. Also, we are going to be using the same race that I previously worked with. We're going to be working with the same race that I previously worked with last time. And is there anything I want to edit? Let's see. Don't think there is, but let me just make sure. Okay, that works. Like that. That. Back. Okay. We're gonna go back. Okay. Everything should be the same. Yeah, we use wormhole travel, where we use nuclear missiles. How this game works, if you haven't seen it played already, is you are given... I'll go ahead and create a new species for you guys, just for you guys, as an example. Okay, first thing you do is you click your species. You have appearance, species name, names list, traits, ruler. I personally really like the fungoid, molluscoid, and arthropod. Types. Really like those for some reason. Don't know why. No clue. I do like that. That looks pretty cool. Maybe a different color scheme though. For example, what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab this guy. Species name. Let's reroll. The Sabtac. Okay. Names list, we get to choose from this. So, if you are, say, arthropod, you have these leader names show up, you have that, or you can create your own. For this one, we'll go with... Joint Expeditionary Fleet, Starfleet Corps. No, for this one, we'll go with, maybe it's Arthropod, Attack Swarm. For this one, we'll go with that. Next, you come and you pick traits. You have four trait picks, but you only have 2 points, so you gotta be careful with what you go with. So, for example, a negative trait, like Decadent, which reduces your output without slaves, or Fleeing, which is minus leader lifespan. Stuff like that adds a point there, but takes away from a trait pick. So, what I like to do is I like to pick something like non-adaptive, which is not going to have that much of an effect in the early game. Pick that. It won't really have a real effect until the middle game, and then you have 4 trait points and 3 traits. So you can pick stuff like, say, intelligent, communal, and natural physicists if you want, just as an example. Then from there, that's your species traits. Each one of these gives your species a bonus or a something that takes away from your species, like habitability. Habitability governs certain planets. Choose sex. Male or female. We'll go with female this time. You can randomly generate a name or create one for yourself. Color variants. You get to pick your first leader's color variant. I think with humans, you get phenotype, hairstyle, and clothes. But, let's go with... I like that one. We'll go with that. And instead of that, we will go with Overlord. Next we get to name and class our homeworld. So we're an insect species, so we'd probably be best suited for something like tundra or continental, tropical, desert, or arid. So these ones. For example, if we do tropical, these two planets here, the Arctic and the tundra, will have next to no habitability, making it very, very difficult for us to maintain a proper happiness with the people who, with the people on our, on that planet. And happiness governs how many resources you get. I mean, all of that's affected. So tropical would probably be a good one for us. So we're going to go with that. Home system name, Hulong, star name Congrim. We can start in the Sol system, the Deneb system, or a random system. We'll do random. City appearance, reptilian, avian, molluscoid, fungoid, arthropod. We're arthropods, so we'll go with an arthropod city. This is where it gets fun. You have a government and you have ethics. Okay. These cost 2 ethics points. These orange ones. These orange icons. However, as you... these ones only cost 1 ethics point. But they don't give as powerful of a bonus. I personally like fanatic materialist and either militarist or pacifist. Pacifist minimizes, it takes away the number of rivalries you have, but you get more trust. You have more peace, happiness, and that's it. However, militarist does not have a negative effect on your peace, happiness. It probably should, but they haven't gotten around to fixing it yet. So war happiness would actually be a good one if you're going to constantly be in war. Not how I recommend playing on a regular basis, but it's something to think about. Trust growth, that's how much other nations trust you and are willing to do trade deals with you. Weapons damage, +3. Maximum rivalries, +1. So, I mean, it's the... Honestly, personally, knowing what I know, I would probably go back and do militarist... and choose that those two to be my ethics. Fanatic materialist and a militarist. Then you get to choose what kind of government you want. There are 15 types. These are the extreme military. These are extreme... Okay, these are extreme military. These are like a theocracy, spiritualistic type of government. These are the middle ground. Then you have moral democracy, peaceful bureaucracy, and like monarchy. And as you go further over to this side, you get more... you get less rights for the people. As you go on this side, you tend to have more rights for the people. You see a lot of democracies and republics. This one, you have middle of the line rights for the people. I like Science Directorate. Science Directorate is awesome. You get more research alternatives and Empire Leader capacity. So we're going to go with that one. This isn't going to be the race we're playing with, but I'm showing it to you. Confederacy of Krongum, Shabtok Polity, Shabtok Coalition, Republic and Shabtok Commonwealth, Shabtok Directorate. There we go. And then we can add an adjective if we want. We're not going to. Then you get to create your flag. We'll go with that. Then you get to pick your starting weapons. You have projectile weapons, energy weapons, and missile weapons. I personally prefer missile weapons. They tend to go through shields. They're vulnerable to interception, though. Projectile weapons tend to go through shields, but not armor. But they can't be intercepted. Energy weapons, it's the opposite. They can go through armor, but not shields real well, I think. No, these ones go through armor. These ones don't go... Wait a second. I may have that mixed up. But anyways, you get to pick your starting weapons. We'll go with missile weapons simply because I prefer that. Now you get to your faster-than-light method. You have warp travel, hyperspace travel, and wormhole travel. I like wormhole travel. Wormhole travel has... You can't move as freely as warp travel because you are given a limited range. But you move a whole lot faster than warp travel. Warp travel is like Star Trek. You generate a subspace bubble around a ship. Faster than light speed is attainable. This allows for free but relatively slow travel between stars, given great distances involved. Personally, don't really care for warp travel that much. Hyperspace travel, I don't like hyperspace travel at all. Because what happens with hyperspace travel is it's very easy to get locked into a certain area with the only way out to go through an enemy. And I really don't care for that. I prefer wormhole travel. It's a lot freer. It's middle of the line between warp travel and hyperspace travel in terms of freedom. And it's a whole lot faster than it's a whole lot faster than warp travel. So we're going to go wormhole travel to start off with. Then you get to pick your ship appearance. I personally like fungoid, molluscoid, and avian most. Arthropod is right after that. I don't care for the mammalian and reptilian ships. I'm hoping they add some more to that later. But for the moment, we'll go with arthropod. And we'll save that. Next... next thing you can do is pick what galaxy you want, but we're not going to do that. We're done. Wait, back. Okay. Shabtok Directorate. You can allow this species that you have created to show up in your regular game instead of a randomly generated empire. That's allowed, that's forced, and then it just won't show up. Allowed means it could show up or it might not. We're gonna keep that and that out. And this is what we're going with. We are pacifists, fanatic materialists, quick learners, intelligent, non-adaptive, communal molluscoids. Our home planet is Y'all. Hi, Y'all. Nuclear missiles and wormhole travel, and then fungoid ships. Because I love the look of the fungoid ships. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I love it. So. And if you're wondering what I am drinking tea. So, let's do this. We are going to go with a large galaxy. We're not going to go with huge. It's just too much to get through before No Man's Sky comes out. We are going to go... Elliptical, I think. Ring is interesting, but it tends to lock you into just one place really, really quickly. And I don't care for that. We are going to have zero starts. We're going to knock the AI empires down to about 10. Difficulty, normal. AI aggressiveness, normal. Allowed FTL method, any. Yeah, we're going to go with any. Iron Man mode, we're going to put Iron Man mode on. Iron Man mode lets you unlock achievements, and it also locks your save. You can only save at the start of each month. So, let's play Stellaris, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry if you already knew that stuff, but I wanted to do it. Just to be clear. Okay. Here we have the Galactic Hydra Directorate. These are all of our traits that we've picked out earlier. In the eons since the first primitive Hydra communities took shape in the archipelagos and lagoons of Yal, our civilization has spread and prospered. Through scientific progress, we have managed to stamp out the superstitions that ruled the minds of our ancestors. As reason and rational thought spread among our people, the inefficient nation states that we had until then organized ourselves into were disbanded, and a council of our most accomplished scientists was gathered to rule in their stead. Now, after the successful creation of artificial subspace wormholes, the finest minds of the Galactic Hydra Directorate have finished construction of the first wormhole station on the edge of our system. The stars themselves are finally within our grasp. Finally, indeed. Okay.
Greetings, Director. I am Veer, a prototype synthetic intelligence developed by the finest minds of our civilization to serve as your advisor. I shall endeavor to perform...
Don't be a fool.
Okay. Hi, guys. Welcome to the stream. Just seeing you on there. Now, give me a moment, and I'm going to adjust my Twitch chat window to there, so that you guys can see it without it getting in the way. Okay, we're paused at the moment, so here's our engineering research. We're going to go ahead and... Really, that's the guy that we have for our physics. A guy with an expertise in industry. I guess maybe it could be useful. I can see that being useful. We're going to go solar panel network first. New Worlds Protocol, that's one that we want... And ion thrusters simply because we can. Okay. Now that we've done that, it's time to send this little shippy out to explore our home system. It'll survey the system, and we have one planet just within our system. Good. Okay. I am watching chat, so if you guys want to talk, feel free. What are we going to do for the moment? Let's see what y'all has. On the surface, we have this basic stuff. These tiles, you can clear these tiles if you need to. We're not going to at the moment, though. What is 4 food surplus? I don't like that. You are going to get us another hydroponics farm. That's what you're going to do. Yes. Because I have said that you will give us... I do love how they built these stars. It's beautiful. Same thing with the planets, too. I love it. I have a fairly large initial system. Okay. What we are going to do is we are going to send the Abyssal Flotilla there, and we're going to press play. So, the weakness of a wormhole type system is you have to reach outside of the gravity well. And so we're also going to bump up the speed. You got to get outside of the gravity well. And once you do that, then you can head to other planets. Oops, there. Send them everywhere. We want all the information. So, the reason I am sending my military fleet in first is so that I don't have to worry about my science ship being sent into an area where there might be hostiles. You go build us a mining station, my homie. Has gained a level. That's good.
Construction complete.
Y'all has finished its surface construction queue. Good. So we should have some more people building up fairly quickly on y'all. And we want that. We want to take full advantage of the resources that we have. Finish building the mining station. Good.
Situation updated.
Interesting. Enigmatic spacefarers.
Hostile fleet engaged.
You guys retreat. Oh dear, and they've come across an anomaly. Okay. Go ahead and research that. Retreat from battle. 3, 2, and retreat. Okay, void cloud. So we know not to go into that system. Let's see what that is about. I'll investigate the alpha aliens. Natural geometrical formation. It almost looks like a marker showing the way forward. Interesting. Get anything from it particularly? Not really. Please tell me we have some minerals here. Yes, minerals. Okay. Minerals are what you build everything with. And I mean everything with. If you don't have minerals, your government will not function for very long.
Situation log updated.
Okay. We'll also investigate the beta aliens. We know not to send guys to Pyridon. Which is unfortunate. Okay. Hopefully we don't come across too many hostiles within this area. That would get very frustrating very quickly. Do you want the details map mode on?
Special project complete.
Special project complete. Void clouds. An investigation into peculiar cluster of debris and space dust has yielded surprising results. It is a particulate void cloud bristling with a powerful charge of unknown origin that has no business exhibiting simple reflexive reactions, let alone movements with purpose. And yet, it does. There is something undeniably ominous about the hazy subject the relayed video feeds. Perhaps there are things in this universe we should not tangle with. Let's watch.
Situation log updated. System survey complete.
Yeah, void cloud. Lots of void clouds in this area. Not a fan. Okay, so we have Pecona Yawl all surveyed. We have next to no minerals, so we're going to send our good little science ship back to Parthavon. The other weakness of wormhole ships is they have to return back to a central point before they're able to progress further in the galaxy.
Situation log updated.
Okay. Search that. Let's go ahead and research the void cloud observation too. The good thing is that at least we have lots of energy in our home system that will make it easier once we do find some minerals. Hopefully we find some minerals quickly, otherwise this is going to be a slow start to a campaign.
Special project complete.
The spaceborne lifeforms, which the head of Hydron Society research has come to refer to as Tianaki, are docile creatures capable of accessing some lower dimension of subspace. They roam from system to system with remarkable ease. They graze on gases common to the upper layers of many gas giants. It is highly unlikely, to say the least, that this is their only food source, but intake of other nutrients has yet to be observed. They will rarely, if ever, attack. Even when provoked, they can safely be ignored. Hunting them would be a net loss anyways.
Situation log updated.
More aliens. Hello.
Special project complete.
Void unclouded. The void clouds are, as far as Hydron researchers can tell, among the oldest entities in the universe. They seem to have originated just a scant few billion years after matter as we know it first appeared. The tremendous forces in the young cosmos making something out of nothing that would have been stars once, but were not. Okay, they will not stand in our way. Get the Cloudbuster modifier. Or we can get a list of likely void cloud systems. Let me go with the Cloudbuster modifier. Seems fairly powerful. Why not? How's this going? Scientist Nuvol, how is this going? Tell me! Three... find me some minerals.
Special project complete.
Communications established with the interstellar Grolfer Nation. After successfully translating their language, we have established communications with the interstellar Grolfer Nation. Diplomatic channels are now open, and all hostilities have been terminated. Wonderful. They're Democratic Crusaders. We're a democratic nation committed to upholding... Okay. We're going to go with Peace Be With You. News that we have encountered alien life for the first time has been received with mixed feelings by our populace. This confirms what we had long suspected. We are not alone in this galaxy. Each new alien species we encounter represents both an opportunity and a threat. We must be wary. These particular Xenos have a history of technology similar to our own, indicating that we achieved space flight at roughly the same time. This changes everything. Just kidding! It changes nothing.
System survey complete.
Really, that's it. That's all you've got for me. We know without a doubt that a thriving biosphere is not something unique to y'all. Both the scientific community and the public at large are easier to learn more about the various forms of alien life throughout the galaxy. Yeah, that's a commendable initiative.
Situation log updated.
You never know what we might get out of that.
Special project complete.
Crystalline entities. Issue a special. We'll review.
Situation log
study.
Updated.
Survey. You can't be surveyed. Okay. What is up here? Yeah.
We shall begin the operation. You may fire when ready.
Not really. We're peaceful. We're pacifists. Right, guys? Right. Do you know what pacifism is? Absolutely not. Go ahead and... No, wait. Whoops. You... Go ahead and build a mining station there. Really, really unfortunate that we have so little in the way of resources.
Special project complete.
Crystalline entities are unbreakable. The name itself is a compromise between rival factions and xenobiologists and xenogeologists. On y'all. Probably alive. We're going to add the prismatic lens. Yeah. We're going to add the prismatic lens, because that will give us a boost to our physics research. And we need all the boost we can get.
Anomaly found.
We'll leave it be for now. Hopefully we can come back to it later, but for the moment, we'll leave it. I think we build some ships.
Situation log updated.
Okay. Can't have gotten far. All of these on the map. hate having to go into another person's space like that, but we don't really have much of an option at the moment.
Construction complete.
Well, I'm going to adjust something real quick.
System survey complete.
Is it? Keep that. Keep that. Twitch. No, we don't want to do that. No. Huh. Okay, maybe I can only do that outside of the game. Oh well. I'm wanting to get the FPS clock, VRAM, and temperature off of my screen, but I guess I can only do that outside of the... They've closed their borders to us! Oh, you guys are gonna be a bad problem. You guys are in trouble! I have to deals with you. Deals with you. Let's see, what do we have? We have 3 months remaining on the solar panel network. That's good. We have 7 months remaining on the ion thrusters. Again, good. And we have 49 months remaining on the New World Protocol. Yeah.
Research complete.
Solar panel network. Good. Fun. Ooh. Or we could go gravitic sensors. I mean, this is tough. We have some stuff that I all really want. Let me go with assist research, though, because that'll help us long term. I'm all about that long-term thinking in this game. It is a strategy game. Put the research station there. Need to find a place with a lot of minerals.
Research complete.
The therium refining. That's... ooh. And again, they give us a bunch of really good ones that I really, really want. We're gonna go with... we're not gonna go with Batherian refining. I think we're gonna go with fusion missiles for the moment. We're not a warlike species, but not having ships that are ready for war is asking for trouble. Come on. Ooh. Yeah, I was streaming Dark Souls earlier, and I may do some more tonight. I'm not sure yet.
Anomaly found.
Ooh. Go ahead and research that. If it's only a 2%, yeah. Let's go ahead and build a science ship. Before we do that, though, let's go into ship designer. The structures on the surface of Talaris Vla are utterly beneath or notice, and their time is better spent elsewhere. Wow. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and bump up all of the transport, all of the ships to a better subspace engines. We may change that later. We may actually send them back to upgrade later, but I like to have a bunch of stuff upgraded rather than just one thing or two things.
System survey complete.
Mining station there. System survey complete. 15% failure risk. Yeah, we're not gonna do that.
System survey complete.
System survey. Wonderful. 5 engineering. Oh, yeah. Neutron star.
Construction complete.
I don't know why we get engineering from going there, but hey, we get engineering for going there. 5 and 1 star is not bad. That would double our current engineering. And I will warn you guys, this is going to be a little bit of a slow start if you haven't noticed already. It just takes a little while for the game to warm up, especially... Go ahead and research that. That's fairly low. Especially when it's early in the game. Once we get out of our comfort zone a little bit and are able to explore a little bit more, we'll certainly... the simulator, the ship is not giving away any heat.
Intrusion. Situation log updated.
Okay. So 2 or higher has 1. Go ahead and get that done first. And then survey the system. I am a lot more interested in that.
Special project complete.
That's just not good. I wonder if this came with the hotfix issue. Install control. No! Oh. Great, so now I gotta build another science ship. And I don't have enough there. That is unfortunate. I didn't realize that you could fail.
Construction complete.
These things. That sort of surprises me.
not only discovered chance. Yeah, we'll go with that. Since you're going to be our explorer type in your future, go ahead and put it there. It'll be our new number 3. Need to go there, survey that system. Survey that system. Survey that system.
Situation log updated. Evading hostile fleet.
Go ahead and evade them. By all means, evade them. And of course, it's an anomaly. Great.
Situation log updated.
Situation log. Wild trail track map. It's in Cursa. Okay, we can deal with that. Build a research station. We need to build up our fleet quickly. Go now. The reason being is we don't want next door neighbors that are equivalent to us, because if they're equivalent to us, that means that they can be a problem. And unfortunately, wait, they look exactly like us. Oh.
Construction complete. System survey complete.
You're not Grawlfurp, you're Hydra. I wonder how the game will treat that, as whether we're separate species or exactly the same. I wonder.
Research complete.
Our colony ship thing's done. Good. And we are going to go with Galactic Ambitions. Order range 20%. Yeah, that should get a couple of smaller ones, like maybe Cagabond, but I bet the only one that's going to come in at the moment is Dim. I'm not sure. And those of you YouTubers who, those of you watching this on YouTube, yes, I will have planets renamed for the, I will have planets renamed for the people who commented in comment section, but at the moment I do not have the list with me, so, but it will be there next time. I will have the list with me next
Research
time I stream.
Complete.
This, and I will start renaming planets. So, research speed. Those are research speed. Go there and build a mining station. Just build it.
alien proto-civilization encountered.
Ooh.
And we can't see the Stone Age primitives. Oh well. And we can't uplift them. Which is unfortunate, but not entirely unexpected.
System survey complete.
Very habitable. Damn, is kind of habitable. Same thing with Talisius. Fourteen, 21. Probably want to go with the 21 size planet. So we'll see though. We'll see. Hello, Placid Leviathan. Months remaining for those two. Good. Good. They have unemployed pops. No. It cannot be. We can't do anything about it at the moment.
Anomaly found.
We'll
construction complete.
Good guys, this is not good. There do not appear to be a large number of minerals in our area. It's not good.
System survey complete.
Not good at all.
Hostile fleet. Science ship under attack.
Not good. What are these? Whales of some sort. Retreat. There we go. Good lad. Good lad. Survey that system. Survey that system. Please don't get killed. Survey that system. The systems that we can actually do anything in are running in very short supply. On screen, despicable neutrals. My credits. Yeah, we have the credits for the moment. Cursa system. Okay. There we go. There we go. That's where we're going to be going. That's the system that we want. We want a frontier outpost as soon as we possibly can. Right there. 6 after we've been working off of 10 is not bad.
Special project complete.
Space Amiibos. Larger than the average Hydran Corvette.
Situation log updated.
Research. Ship-wise, 148. You'll need more before I feel ready to send them out for any military targets. Equivalent in every way. That's frustrating.
Special project complete.
Flagellating movement modifier gives the following effects: 5 evasion.
System survey complete. Anomaly found.
Let it be for now. We do not have a good history with anomalies. We're just gonna leave it. I'm lacking 7 minerals. Oh dear.
Station under attack. Evading hostile fleet. Science ship under attack.
Gotta be kidding me.
Evading hostile fleet. Hostile fleet engaged.
Space station, guys.
Situation log updated.
Science ship, come here and research project. Research the project. System, you start building. So we're going to need as many of these mining stations as we can get.
Debris analyzed.
Amoeba breeding program. That's new or something I've never seen before. Amoeba strike craft. Okay. Interesting. I have 6 months on my fusion missiles, 2 months on my research speed, 45 months on my galactic ambitions.
It is all going according to plan.
Research complete.
Magnificent. Gravetic sensors. We'll do that. Scientist is leveled up. Good for you, scientist. No, I said survey the system and then you go and repair. Does that not make any sense to you?
Research complete.
Fusion missiles. Magnificent. Let's go mining network 2. We're gonna need all the minerals we can get. Placid Leviathan's gas crystals. Love you guys. You're space whales. Well, I like
system
space
survey
whales.
Complete.
Guess what? Guess what? After that, guess what? You get to work on building mining stations. Yes. Mining station there, mining station there, and then you get to go all the way out there. Rather than 10, that really help us build faster, build more stuff. So really bad. Hegemony, it's a science directorate. Not a hegemony. Or all. need to find a safe place. I think we go Taliesin. We've been a little bit closer to the galactic core than I'd like, because it means we'll be a little bit more easily surrounded. At least with your back against the wall, you have some way of knowing that you're not going to get attacked from the rear. So yeah, we'll go out into the outer part of the galaxy. See the little drones building it. Go home and take a break. And be mothballed. I just don't have anything else for you to do at the moment. You guys, on the other hand, get to build a couple more Corvettes for me.
So that I can begin deploying.
Construction complete.
Gravitic sensors is 8 months out, geothermal fracking 7 months out, and galactic mission ambitions. 15 months remain.
Construction complete.
I think I'm only going to go about another 10 minutes before I call it an episode. I want to have some time to read tonight. I know, reading. But I love it. It'd be cool. It'd be cool to stay in school. So stay in school, kids. Months, 3 months, 10 months. Wonderful. We have fusion missiles, so I'm gonna go into here to replace them. Overwrite all the saves. We have to decide, do we want a mineral processing plant? That's plus 10. Or do we go with the improved spaceport?
I think we go mineral processing. But we're going to pause, and we are going to change out him with him. Yes. We're not doing that. You get the maniacal guy. There we go. That's a much better setup. Because he's going to do this in 29 months rather than what it would have been a lot more than that. And he's going to get everything done in this section done faster rather than just some of it. Observatories. We're going to do... do deflectors first. Later we'll deal with basic combat roles. That's a terrible idea, guys. Terrible, terrible idea.
Construction complete. Research complete.
Research complete. Wonderful. Yes, we did get Tim within our... Did we get anything else? No, we did not. Okay. That's fine. That's fine. Not too concerned about it. What do we want to do for our next bit of research? Influence is always good, so we're going to go with influence.
Ships upgraded. Construction complete.
Now, you guys are going to go over to Dim and deal with the sublight probe. I am going to assign you a leader. Gale speed, trickster, Gale speed. Let's go Gale speed. Since we have such a wonderful young general. You are going to come up here and build a wormhole station there.
Hostile fleet engaged.
I know there's something here. Thank you. tip. And we got physics research.
Situation log updated.
The only thing we get out of them is one physics. What do you want to bet it's on the planet that we get? Huh? And it is! Oh! Gee, thanks, guys. So if I build a research station there, I'll lose it when I eventually colonize. What a wonderful idea! Oh. You guys go heal up. Welcome to the live stream, guys. Good to have you here. I am in chat, so if you guys want to talk to me, you can. So. We are playing Stellaris. And it is a slow start. We have not had... I've been playing for an hour, and we have not had hardly anything go our way. Got a bad starting system in terms of minerals, and we want minerals right off the bat, so makes it a little bit frustrating. I think we save up for a colony ship and then go for Telassus. Up the speed a little bit.
Debris
faster.
Analyzed.
Wonderful. Ooh, cloud lightning circuits, regenerative whole tissue, physics research.
Research complete.
Okay. Let's see. What do we got here? Improved assist research, and that bumps it up to 10% speed, but that's a ways off. I don't think we're gonna go for that. Fusion reactor. That sounds good. That sounds wise to me. It sounds like wisdom. So how you doing today? Since you're the only one watching the stream. Did you have a good 4th of July? Or at least, XSplit's telling me that you're the only person watching the stream. Not that it was paused. No wonder it's not working.
Research complete.
Good. Good. Not ready for antimatter missiles yet. But I do like the idea of an engineering facility. That.
Research complete.
Propaganda broadcast finally got done. Good. Empire leader capacity plus 2. Edict costs. Whoops. Not what I meant to do. Let's see. Let's I think we go adaptive bureaucracy. Because we don't really have much of an army. We don't really have much of a need for an army. We have orbital hydroponic farms. We don't need orbital hydroponic farms at all. That makes no sense to get. These are all well out of our reach for the moment. I think adaptive bureaucracy is the way to go. Empire leader capacity. Okay. And let's go ahead and have our construction ship go there and build a research station. Why not? Makes sense. Sure. Let's go do that. Corvette. Construction ship. Colony ship. There we go. We're about ready to go. Yeah! Building our first colony! We're materialist fools. You would say that, you spiritualists. We are the Hydra. And just because you are mocking our species, or possibly our brothers because of alien kidnappers. I haven't worked that out yet. I'm not sure. Because you are mocking our species, we are going to take control of you. Roll for
research complete.
Subspace sensors. That sounds neat. Active countermeasures or cloud lightning circuits. Knowing from experience, the cloud lightning circuit conduits are not that big of a deal. Once you get up to about +2 weapons, you can normally beat them. Sentinel point defense sounds good. Same thing with AI-controlled colony ships. We'll go with that since we're developing the colony anyways, and it won't be ready by the time the first one gets done, but it might be ready by the time the second one gets done. There are advantages to having a maniacal guy. Build a wormhole station there, buddy. Do your good deed, lad.
Construction complete.
Go ahead and military fleet get going there. Our colony ship is here. Wonderful. You guys go and colonize. What do I want you guys to colonize? That's a good question. You know what? Colonize there. Talassus Prime. That'll do for the moment. Later we'll name it. Modifications of an alien origin. On screen. Are you the makers? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Either way, the modified probe changes to hostile.
Situation log updated.
Then you shall die. Aye, aye, aye.
Hostile fleet engaged.
This is what happens when you give an AI little remains and strange alien modifications that are missing sublight probe had been subjected to, but we did manage to collect some valuable engineering data from the wreckage. The memory bank has also been salvaged. That's good. Science ship. You get up there. You do research projects. You do many good research projects. Military, there. Hush, little bad guys, don't say a word.
Research complete.
Talking to you guys. Golferb. I despise you. Auto cannons. No, I don't think so. The Therian refining would be good. I can see how that would be good, so we're gonna go with that. Fortunately, we have a very large supply of energy credits, so the dropping that's first Hydra colony. Yeah. One hostile fleet. Ah, there. We'll deal with you guys later. We have stuff to deal with at the moment. Yes, that's right. Stuff
to more important analyzed.
Crystalline entities. And we got nothing. Great. Magnificent. That system. Survey that system. Survey that system. We are having no luck at all with our areas. We are surrounded by hostiles, including one completely sentient nation. It's not a great position to start with.
Situation log updated.
Iota aliens. These are... mammals? I believe. Go ahead and research them.
Hostile fleet engaged. Hostile fleet engaged.
Why exactly are we in combat with these guys? Please tell me it's not...
Situation log updated.
Oh dear. We're in their home world, aren't we?
Situation log updated.
No. You guys get back and out. And you guys...
Colony established.
You're avoiding Dweeb. Colony established. Okay. Good. You guys go repair.
System survey complete. Special project complete.
Ancient mining drones. Is that... reports of deep space drones in certain systems have been investigated. The drones appear to be the workers and custodians of an autonomous orbital mining operation established millennia ago, and then soon abandoned by all but the drones themselves. Huh. Okay.
Situation log updated.
Mining drone observation. Go ahead and research them. Birth of space piracy. Oh no! Nonconformists will be dealt with. The Merry Marauders. Oh boy. Yeah. Merge.
Station under attack.
You guys are a pirate fleet. You guys are in Cursa. Biologists have collected a massive amount of data.
Special project complete.
Drone work ethic. Those are remarkably efficient at squeezing ever-diminishing returns from rocks, and hybrid miners were soon discarded. Deemed exhausted of all worthwhile mineral contents. Mineral rich planetoids to a situation. Ooh. Hmm. Foundation's edicts. We'll find out how they evaluate themselves. I want the minerals, but not that much.
Station under attack.
Oh, please don't tell me they're going to be able to destroy that. You guys
hostile fleet engaged. Construction
there
complete.
We go.
Anomaly found.
Go ahead and research it, I guess. And we lost a ship. Doggone it. Guys, go get repaired. We have to find out where are these guys
research
coming
complete.
From. Used to be a pristine continental planet with a mild climate as little as 1,000 years ago. In stark contrast, the atmosphere today is extremely toxic, the surface highly irradiated, and the world has lost the ability to support life. Thermonuclear war. Wow. Good. Ooh, Paradise Stone. That would be useful. I'm going to do either that or probably Biolab. Happiness and habitability. I think that's going to be a little bit more important than a Biolab at the moment. So we'll be taking that. And I think we're going to continue next time, guys. Because at the moment... At the moment, it's pretty slow. I've been doing this for about an hour and a half, so I want to take a break. If you guys have enjoyed this, I have a link to my YouTube page in the bio for the in the bio of my profile here on Twitch. If you guys are watching this on YouTube, I hope you guys have enjoyed it. And in the meantime, guys, I guess I will see you next time. Live long and prosper. May the force be with you. May the odds be ever in your favor. May the drinks be ever in your flavor. May Batman never need to visit your house at midnight. Same thing with Chuck Norris. Have a great day, guys. Stay safe out there. And goodbye.